Good morning, Soul Tribe. I am back in the US of A, tested negative for COVID, y'all. This is this week's forecast. This is Renee Asiri with InsideJobHealing.com, coming to you live from New Mexico. So this week is pretty chill astrologically, but remember I told you last week was like magical, and it all culminated in the new moon in Pisces on Saturday, and now I understand why the guides told me to come to Mexico from the 7th to the 12th. And let me tell y'all, I barely made it back and made my connecting flight in Denver and missed the snowstorm, hashtag manifestation. Anyway, so, you know, this, I didn't talk about the new moon in Pisces last week, so let me just kind of recap a little bit of the energies, because new moons affect us like 3 or 4 days before and after, so we're still in that period. So, as you know, Pisces is the airy sign. It's the sign of oneness and spirituality and intuition and all that good stuff. And so I was in the perfect place in the jungles of Tulum, Mexico, where the Maya had, you know, done all their beautiful energetic work for hundreds of years, to be experiencing that energy. And it just was like, if you think about it, Pisces is the last sign of the zodiac, and it was a new moon, which is new beginnings. So it was almost like completions and new beginnings at the same time, ending karmic cycles, letting go of the past. And I remember in Temescal with Memo, Mitch, Christian, and his dad, like, I remember us saying like, afuera, afuera, which means like outside. And so I personally was like chanting like all past mistakes, everything that I've done that I haven't forgiven myself for or whatever. I just was like outside, outside, outside of me. And they just made like this really powerful statement that just kind of reminds us like to thoughts are, right? Like thoughts are spells, right? And you create your own reality. So always, always, always say positive affirmations. And we were saying things like, I'm the healthiest person in the world. I have the best partner in the world. So it's just like acting as if, and the power of putting intention out into the universe. So I really encourage you to do that if you haven't already done that, and use some of that, still that new moon energy that's hanging around. And so, yeah, so it just was like such a powerful Temescal experience to have around this time. So just remember right now, a lot of us that have let go of the past, that have done our work, that have cut out toxic people in our lives, starting back in December, and just like invited people that are more in alignment with us in 5D, those of us that have done that and let go of the past and completed karmic cycles, it's like we're no longer bound. We're no longer bound by the emotional baggage of the past, the karma of the past, the poverty of the past, the limited thinking, right? Like all of the bad patterns, all of the struggles, like we're done with that now, right? This marks the completion of that. And so for those of us that have done the work, we feel free. So right now in the collective, some of us feel free, right? And we don't feel, you know, tied to the past anymore. We feel like there's no obstacles. In fact, when I did this Teotl experience sound healing, I got visions of past lives, and I got this really amazing message from this Indian chief that there are like no obstacles. And that was echoed through so many different astrological reports that I was listening to. So if you've done the work, there's no past, there's no obstacles, the karmic cycles have ended, and it's really time for you to start anew. So this is such exciting news. We've been working our ass off, and this week's really easy and really chill. And something else I wanna mention, like when I came to Tulum, because as you know, I not only heal myself and my ancestors and my clients, but I also heal the collective. That's why I do these energy reports for the collective, because I'm really tuned in to what's going on energetically for us as a group, because we're all one. So if we have the new moon in Pisces, which is the sign of spirituality and oneness, right? A lot of us have let go of this like isolation and separation and, you know, energy, because we've had that for months and months and months with COVID. And I don't know about you, but when I came to Mexico, I was like, I'm craving socialization with like-minded people and spiritual peeps in the tribe. I'm craving connection and magic and synchronicity and manifestations and music and events and dancing. And I'm like craving all these things. I'm craving community, right? And I feel like that's exactly what I got. So for a lot of us, we've been able to transmute this separation consciousness that unfortunately we've been in the grips of since Saturday. Saturn in 2020 with COVID. So really, it's now about time to let go of that isolation, to start coming into community, to start finding your tribe, to start kumbayaing and start connecting. And let me tell you what a beautiful feeling that is, to, you know, feel the oneness and the unity consciousness. So I highly encourage you to cultivate that in your own life if you haven't already, because trust me, you'll feel so much better. So this week's pretty chill. So last week was like super amazing with all the spiritual energy and creativity and magic. Now I do have to say I'm a little bit disappointed because Venus is no longer exalted in Pisces. It's actually in a sign it doesn't like too much, which is Aries. So that just kind of like, Venus is a relationship sign, so it kind of has more of a selfish approach to relationships. So it's not in the best placement right now. So boohoo, and Venus is, like we said, all about beauty and harmony and relationships and resources. So, but you know what? Like I always say, it's only temporary. Now, something else that moved into a placement that's not super great on Monday, and I felt it yesterday. I wonder if you did too. Shoot me a message or comment below if you have. But essentially, Mercury moved into the sign of Pisces. Mercury, as you know, is the communication planet. It's all about logic and thinking and air and mental energy. And so it moved into this very like watery, murky, intuitive, imaginative, creative sign. So as you can tell, it's really not a good placement for Mercury either. So even though we celebrate that we're out of Mercury post-shadow period, which happened recently, I believe on like March 13th or something like that, now Mercury is not in the best placement. And so yesterday I was doing my 2020 taxes, y'all. Do them if you want your $1,400, your check, right? By the way, it doesn't show up on the 2020 taxes. It only shows up for the $600 and $1,200 from last year. But hopefully we'll be getting our money soon for those that are my American peeps. But anyway, so I was doing my taxes and like the internet kept cutting out and I had to use, thank God I had my iPhone hotspot. But again, technology, communication, those are all Mercurian things, right? So basically, you're gonna feel it. And then I had a bunch of miscommunication with friends, and then a friend had miscommunication with others. So we're already feeling that Mercury does not like to be in Pisces. So just a heads up, guys, it is a very creative sign. You might think of like, you might receive messages more in thoughts and completions and imaginative things, and maybe not have the right words or not feel understood. That's because Mercury is in Pisces. So just a heads up. I did talk about the fact that Mars has moved into Gemini, which is amazing because it was in Taurus, which was slow moving, kind of likes to stay in its comfort zone. And now it's in this very dynamic sign of Gemini. And so it has this momentum. So all good things that, so take advantage of that because there's going to be momentum with Mars being placed in Gemini. And also, I was talking to somebody on the plane from Denver over here, and she was saying, like, I feel like so busy. And I told her the same thing that, I was like super duper busy in Mexico. I saw who I wanted to see. I ate what I wanted to eat. I did every sort of spiritual ceremony. I was open to receiving, especially with Venus being a feminine sign of receiving. So again, this is also a really great time to receive, guys. So just cultivate that, feel worthy of that. It's also, Venus is our self-worth. So definitely, Neptune was conjuncting Venus just this past weekend. So just make sure that you are open to receiving, because trust me, for you to be abundant and wealthy and have all these blessings come from the universe, you first have to be open to receiving, right? So back to the story. So she was telling me, she's like, why was I feeling so busy and overwhelmed last week and it feels like everything's picking up? And I told her, I'm like, because all the planets are direct. So I don't know if you guys know this, but since we're done with Mercury retrograde, all the planets are direct until April 27th, and that's when Pluto goes retrograde. So this is the time to get your projects done, to get all your ducks in a row. Remember, I've been saying like, spring is the best time, for your creative projects, for your launches, you're writing a book, if you're wanting to teach a digital course, if you want to study, if you want to, go on that trip or whatever, spring's amazing and so is fall. So just take advantage of that energy, because once we hit April 27th, then we're going to start having planets go retrograde again. And you know how that goes. Everything kind of like slows down. Things feel different. So take full advantage if you're trying to buy a house or launch that business or that partnership or that project or whatever it is. You know, this is the time because you have Mars, you have the momentum, you have all the planets direct. And this is a really good week because, you know, because you have just, you know, Mars is nicely aspected with Saturn. So whatever you start this week is going to be long lasting. It's, you know, right now, if you notice, I'm a little bit scattered because I am a Gemini and then Gemini's in Pisces. So, and then Mars is in Gemini. And so right now it's like you might be thinking all these thoughts and wanting to start all these things. So don't worry if you feel kind of a little scattered or all over the place and not truly organized because Mars is a nice placement with Saturn, which means whatever you start will be long lasting. So, all right, you guys, well, this is it for me. This is a pretty chill week to get stuff done. So just make sure that you do take advantage of these energies because next week's gonna be a little bit intense because we're gonna have the full moon in Libra and then we're gonna have like a conjunction to, you know, to Mercury and Mars and all that. So basically enjoy this week. Get stuff done. let go of your victim consciousness. Let go of your separation consciousness. Invite abundance in and just live your best life, all right? So if you are moving, like a lot of my friends, and are interested in knowing where the heck in the world should I move? And if you want to be supported astrologically, whether it's in your love life or business partnerships, or whether it's in your home life, or whether it's in your career, hit me up and we can schedule a astrocartography reading. And it'll help you understand based on your birth chart astrologically where there is a really great place for you to live that will amplify that. And if you have a partner, we would do it for both you and your partner and choose something that's mutually beneficial. So Rena Yassiri with InsideJobHealing.com. I love you guys.